The organizational chart block is used to represent hierarchical relationships between a group of items. One of the most common use cases for this is showing the relationship between employees in an organization in a visual format. Now, let's quickly see how this block works. It's important to note, first off, that this block is available to our professional plan subscribers, and at the time of this recording, only works with Airtable as a data source. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using the employee directory template, available for free in the Softr template library. So I've gone ahead and copied this template into my Softr studio, and I've actually already connected my Airtable database. As you can see here, we have a simple org chart showcasing the executive team and their relationships. If I hit preview, you can see here that we have our employees listed out. And then if you click into this toggled number here, you'll see that each employee has a certain amount of employees underneath them. So let's try recreating this for our tutorial. Now, before we even add a new block and connect our Airtable base, we want to head into our Airtable database and ensure everything is set up properly. Here you can see we have a database that consists of 5 different tables. So we have an employee directory or users table, an employee time off tab, expenses, departments, and office locations. The users table or employee directory is the table we want to connect to our organizational block. The users table is a simple list of organizational employees with fields such as email, name, position, profile photo, department, manager, and more. Now, the manager field here is a really important one as it's used to establish the relationships between the employees. Therefore, let's take a quick look at it in greater detail. So the manager field, you can really call it anything, is where you establish these hierarchical relationships that we see visually here on the organizational chart. Now, it's a parent relationship. So for each employee, you need to select the person that he or she reports to. Now, here's the important bit. The manager field needs to be a linked record field that's linked to the same table. So as you can see here, we have it selected as linked to another record, and we want it to link to this same table, the employee directory. That way you can map your employees to other employee records within this same table. So I'm gonna hit save. And as you can see here, for every employee, we have a linked record linking the employee to the same table within the organization. Great. Now, one quick thing to note when you set up your linked record field, you want to make sure allowing linking to multiple records is disabled. Since the organizational chart doesn't allow to define a parent relationship to more than one record. So you want to make sure that this is just toggled off. Okay, so now that our Airtable data is set up properly with our users table, we have our individual employees, their employee type, and then we also have the linked record that shows who they report to within the same table. So let's proceed to mapping the fields to our chart block. Headed back into the studio, I'm gonna add a block, and we're gonna scroll down to dynamic and organizational chart. Great. So first we want to connect our data source as we would with any other dynamic block. So our Airtable base is employee directory by Softr, and the Airtable table is going to be the employee directory table. Great. Now let's pop over to the features tab. And if you follow along on any of our previous videos, this should be pretty straightforward to you. The features tab is where we essentially map the item fields to the specific dynamic block. Now, first you have the option to add a title or subtitle to your chart. I'm gonna leave them as is since this is just a demonstration. Next, let's head down to org chart settings. There are 5 fields we're gonna map to the Airtable table we set up previously. First, we wanna define the manager field, which as we recall is the manager. So it's actually titled relationship field in Softr. So I'm going to choose manager. Next, we need to showcase the name of the employee. So let's go here, type in name. great. You can see the data is already showing up. So let's also show their image. And then their role, which we have here as job title. Lastly, their department. Great. Now I'm going to delete this block just so we don't get confused about our work. And let's quickly hit preview. Cool. So as you can see, we're only being shown 4 employees right now. But if you notice the number and toggle here, that shows there's more dependencies linked within that record. So if we simply click, Softr will reveal the remaining dependencies or employees that report to that person. Now, if you hover over the org chart settings, you'll notice this toggle icon appears. Simply click into it and you have just a few styling options for the individual cards. So if you want to change the background of the card, you can do so here. Additionally, you can add a border and you can adjust the roundness of the individual cards. Then I'll hit publish and my org chart is done. And there you have it, a simple org chart that takes less than 5 minutes to set up. This is a great block if you're using Softr for internal tooling, such as an employee portal, directory, or a sales CRM. Really, you can use it for anywhere that you want to show a hierarchical relationship between a group of items.